Hello, Assalamualaikum. I know it has been a long, long time, and the last time I met you was on my niece's birthday. It was 6 months ago, and a lot has changed after that. And I have to talk a lot of stuff with you guys. I made a lot of videos, a lot of vlogs, but I didn't have enough time to edit them, and then I lost my data. And now we are just going to have this heart-to-heart conversation because I don't have the data to show you, which is actually very sad. I have my laptop. I have written literally everything here that I'm going to talk about today with you guys. I know a lot of the people have a lot of the questions when I post my sticker on my Instagram. So I'm going to answer everything today. So first thing first, I moved to UK. It was right after my niece's birthday. I got the job. I think I knew about the job even on my niece's birthday. Actually, yeah, I knew about that. I knew about that at the time, and I think I resigned from my current job at the time, and then I just moved after a month or something. Wait, let me turn on this light as well. I think that's better now. So the second thing, how I got the job is a really long story, but I'll try to make it short. Last year, a lot of the things have changed that I feel like it has been years, but it has not been. It has only been 1 year. Last year, my husband moved as a student to UK, and at the time, student dependent visas were open. I mean, if a student can come to UK, he can bring his wife or she can bring her husband to UK with them. But it changed. So when he was leaving, we decided to get our nikah done. We got married. I applied my visa after him, and then I got my visa as a dependent. I honestly had no intention to move to UK before, like, officially getting married, like the rukhsati and stuff. But I came to collect my BRP in December, which you guys would already know. I already made vlogs about it. I posted my whole trip on YouTube. But if you are a new follower, I came to UK just to enjoy, have fun for vacation, and also to collect my BRP. And I went back. I didn't think I would move here until, like, officially getting married, like rukhsati, not officially. I was officially married, obviously, but then I went back to Pakistan, and then me and my husband thought I should be applying here. When I have a right to work, I should be working here. I mean, my job in Pakistan was really good. I was earning money through Instagram as well. But then I decided maybe it would be better if I come here and, you know, just accelerate the whole process. I will have to come here after getting married, and then I will have to find a job. I will be jobless for a while. And I didn't like that idea, honestly. I don't think after my degree, there was even a month where I was unemployed, and it just, I was honestly scared. So I started applying in Pakistan, and I applied for like 2 months, actually 1 whole month. And then I landed some interviews. I had interviews with a lot of the companies, actually. I gave interview in Amazon as well, with no intention of joining Amazon. I know a lot of people will say, why would Amazon hire you? I had no intention of joining Amazon because I felt like Amazon was not the place for me at the time, because there was too much happening at Amazon. The job market was bad. There were a lot of people getting fired and everything else. I don't know. I don't want to trash Amazon. I'm sure it's an amazing place, but I just didn't feel like it was for me at the time. There were other big companies as well. And for the two companies that I gave interviews, I actually made it to the last interview. There are like 5 or 6 stages of interviews that you have to give, and maybe sometimes they give you an assignment or a live test or something. And for the two companies, I went to the last interview, and then they chose some other candidate, which I was maybe okay with, and sometime I was not. I mean, one time I felt really bad because I really liked the team, and I felt like the environment was really fun and creative, but it wasn't really technical. I am a technical person. I would really want to be in a technical field, so I thought maybe Alamia has something better for me. And that's what exactly happened. When the second month started, I landed interviews in a very good organization, and I obviously made it to the last. I gave all the interviews. There were like 5 stages of interviews, with my manager, with my manager's manager, and then I had interview with some other person from the product team, and then another person from management, and it was nice. Honestly, I really liked the team. I really liked the organization. At the end, I got the offer, and the offer was really, really good. It was technical role, which obviously I wanted. I landed a very good offer in terms of salary as well. So I really liked it. And obviously I said yes. Then I resigned from my job at Teradata, and I left Teradata after like maybe 1 year. And I honestly felt really bad because I'm not the person who would leave companies like after a year or two or something. And but yeah, life had something else for me, and I really wanted to explore it. I resigned, I left Teradata, I booked my flight, and I packed my whole life in like 2 suitcases, not even 2, it was just 1, and 1 hand carry. And yeah, I moved. And when I moved, obviously, my husband was already here to support me and everything. He found me an accommodation. It has been, I think, 6 months at this job, and I'm really, really enjoying it. It's really nice. Then obviously, once my probation ended, I found my own accommodation. By own accommodation, I mean that I could, you know, go to the agencies and ask them to, you know, find me a good place, and that's what I did. This is the place that I rented. Now that I think about it, it's a really long process, and it's a really tough process to find an accommodation in London or maybe in the whole UK. It was hard, honestly. I mean, I wouldn't think it was hard for me, but I would think that a person who come to this country and he's new at the job and stuff, it's really hard. It's not that easy. Even if you have all the things, even if your salary is like a good amount, I feel like even if the landlord doesn't like you, they wouldn't just give you their house. That's how it is. I mean, it, at the end, it's their choice. And we will talk about this some other time. It was honestly, it was really nice. The whole experience was really nice for me. I saw a lot of places, a lot of houses, but I liked this one the most. This is not the house tour that I'm going with right now, maybe some other time. I'm obviously thinking to buy a lot of stuff after I get married and my husband moves in with me, and that would be really nice. And I'm definitely going to make another video about the whole thing, how you rent in the UK and what is required and stuff like that. I would really love to make it because I know it's a long process, and I've seen a lot of videos, and a lot of videos had some information but not a lot of it, so maybe I would be of help to anyone. But it was, I mean, the experience is tough, it's not easy, but it was, I mean, it was nice for me, but it is not nice for everyone. What else do I have to tell you guys? Okay, let's see what else I needed to talk about. And about the job and everything, how you should prepare for it, your resume, your everything. Maybe I will talk about it in some other video, because this video is not about that. This video is about the life updates, my life updates. And on to the next update. Next update is that I am finally getting married. I got married, I know, before, but this time I'm having proper send-off, and I'm having like proper South Asian traditional wedding. Which is going to be 6 days long, or maybe 7 days long, or even more. You don't know until you actually go in there, because there are a lot of dholkis that are happening every other day, or maybe every day. You never know. But the official events are 4 or 5. Yeah. So maybe 5 day long wedding. And I'm really excited about that, honestly. And then I'm going to spend some time with my in-laws, and I'm really excited about that as well. And then I will be coming back to UK with my husband, obviously. And honestly, I'm very stressed out about the whole wedding thing, because I'm a bride, and that's how brides are. You would know, and if you don't know, you should know. Every day when I'm sleeping, I'm thinking about my wedding. I'm thinking about my wedding looks and everything. And I have to change my mehndi venue, which is so exhausting. And I can't wait to go back to Pakistan and do all this stuff. My family and my sisters are doing everything right now, but I want to be there. I am the person who does all her stuff herself. So I really don't want to depend on anyone. I mean, I know they will do it, but I feel like I need to be there. I need to do it myself. And that's how I am. And that's what I'm gonna do. I have to go shopping. I have to buy a lot of gifts for a lot of people, for my family and for Ali's family as well. And I'm really excited to go shopping. I love shopping, obviously. I'm very excited and nervous. and obviously stressed out, I already mentioned. And I'm going to be vlogging more. I'm going to show you the whole process of my wedding, whatever happens, and I'm really excited, and I hope you guys stay along, and I hope you guys enjoy. I think this is it. These are the only updates that I have right now. I'm going shopping tomorrow, so I will take you guys with me in the next vlog. So that is it. Thank you for watching. This is what my life has been. Yeah, pretty much it. Bye.